What's up, Rams? My name is Leah Cackowski, back once again as your Thursday night sports anchor, and here to fill you in on everything you'll need to know about CSU athletics entering this weekend, including an inside look into some options for the transfer portal to help fill out men's basketball's roster for next year. Plus, I'll also dive into Colorado State club baseball and the world of funding for Division I sports. So let's jump right into the action. Yeah, I'm not going to lie, I've really missed being able to talk about Rams hoops ever since the season came to a close just a couple of weeks ago. But hey, there's still a lot going on in the world of college basketball now that March Madness has played out and it's officially the off season. So maybe just because I want an excuse to talk about this team again, or in reality, this stuff matters a lot when it comes to how next year will shake out. Let's talk about this whole college basketball transfer market, and more importantly, which guys are leaving other programs and could actually find their way to Fort Collins. To get things going, any college hoops player has until April 31st to enter the transfer portal and start assessing their options for going elsewhere. And when it comes to the Rams, Adam Thistlewood, Deshaun Thomas, and Jalen Scott have all started that process. Oh, and not to mention that the graduation of Chandler Jacobs leaves yet another open scholarship, meaning the Green and Gold now have four open spots on their roster. But hey, I wouldn't worry if I were you. Due to the outstanding success that was last season and energy this squad brought to the basketball world, I think that recruiting and getting a few guys from other schools should not be too big of a challenge. So let's take a look at some potential options for the Rams. In my mind, I think CSU's top priorities first and foremost have to be finding another big man that can be effective within the offense now that Deshaun Thomas is gone, in addition to a sharpshooter at guard that can come in and out throughout the game and knock down some clutch buckets. With Isaiah Stevens' graduation coming next year and the potential loss of David Roddy due to the NBA draft, Coach Medved and crew needs to find some long-term replacements to fill the voids these two stars will leave behind. Not to mention making up some ground after losing several guys to the portal. So, with all of that in mind, one of the top-ranked transfers at the moment is point guard Najel Pack from Kansas State. He averaged 17.4 points per game in his last 29 games for KSU, and still has 3 years of eligibility left, which is amazing for this program. If he lands here in FOCO, he'll bring some high-level shooting and young leadership as early as next season. And needless to say, I think he could be a great fit here at CSU to fill one of those open guard spots. And speaking of point guards, Andre Curbelo from Illinois is another guy to watch out for. His sophomore season never took off due to a concussion he suffered his freshman year, but like Coach Medved always loves, he's solid on defense and still has a lot of potential to turn into one of the best guards in the Mountain West. And finally, when you look at the need for a big man, 6'10" forward from Murray State, KJ Williams would be amazing to see in this offense and could easily be the playmaking guy that we need, with an average of 18 points a game and 8.4 rebounds. Overall, though, I think the future is going to be bright for this CSU squad, regardless of who they get in the portal, especially with Coach Medved extending his contract through 2029. So it's really just a matter of finding which players will be in it for the long run and can continue to carry the basketball school culture we have here on campus now for the years to come. And now moving on from the court to the diamond, one thing I can't stop thinking about this time of year is baseball. But why isn't there an official school-sponsored team here at CSU? Well, I'll show you. So for background, I grew up in a very baseball-oriented home. I've been to plenty of College World Series, and I always love when springtime comes around. But I've always been super bummed that CSU doesn't have a D1 program. But that wasn't always the case. It actually got cut in 1992, and I have a very close family friend who was on the very last season before it got cut. And he actually helped start the club program that we have today. So shout out Joel Cantalamesa. But CSU currently has a minimum 16 varsity sports, 10 for women and 6 for men. Baseball unfortunately got cut because of Title IX violations in the late 80s and 90s. This was because there was not enough fair qualities for men and women's sports, so baseball unfortunately got the short straw and softball still stands today. Another thing is budget management, and I'll get to that in a minute, but a lot would have to happen in order to bring the sport back. one of the top priorities would be to add another women's sport. They'd have to have the same level of scholarship and funding, and that's a very difficult thing to achieve. Because right now, CSU would need at least $1 million or more dollars each year to fund baseball alone, and that doesn't even include facilities. CSU received nearly $15 million for athletics in 2018, and almost $6 million of that came from student fees alone. So it's hard enough to add a one sport, but yet on top another women's sport. But what about some other programs to keep in mind? Men's soccer, tennis, wrestling, and a lot more have been discontinued as well. Gymnastics and women's field hockey have also been discontinued. So it would just be really difficult to add in another sport. Because I know a lot of programs want that spot just besides baseball, like our lacrosse team and rugby. In conclusion, for Colorado State to even consider adding baseball back into the picture, more funding, budget redistribution, and an addition of a women's sport would have to be in order for it to even potentially work. Hopefully, this will be a reality in the future, even if it's not going to happen at my time at CSU. But well, Rams, that is all the news that we have for you tonight. Be sure to tune in to Monday for another edition of Monday Night Sports. Stay safe, have a wonderful weekend, and we'll see you then.